Good morning, my dear children. Hope you all are staying healthy and safe at home. Welcome back to your English class, children. Today we are going to study an easy and interesting poem, A Boy's Song, written by James Ogg. Okay. Yes, children, before starting the poem, I would like to ask a question. How many of you like to play in nature with your friends, children? Yes, almost everybody likes to play in nature, no? Yes. Yes, children. Like jumping, hopping, skipping, rolling, and also making noise with your friends, right? Yes. Why do you like to play in nature, children? Why? Because it's a beautiful place, right? And also we get fresh air in nature, right? Yes. Yes. That is the reason we like to play in nature, no, children? Yes. Today, so we are going to learn a new poem which is related to nature. Understood, children? So the name of the poem is A Boy's Song, written by James Ogg. So before starting the poem, children, let us know few points about the poet. James Ogg was a Scottish poet, novelist, and also an essayist. And he spent most of his youth as a shepherd and was mostly self-educated. And also, children, his famous works are The Queen's Wake, Jacobite Relics, The Three Perils of Man, and The Three Perils of Woman. Okay, yes, children. Now, let us see the summary of the poem. Before starting the summary, I will read the poem once, children. Yes. Where the pools are bright and deep, where the great trout lies asleep, but the river and over the lea, that's the way for Billy and me. Where the blackbird sings the latest, where the hawthorn blooms the sweetest, where the nestlings chirp and flee, that's the way for Billy and me. Where the mowers mow the cleanest, where the hay lies thick and greenest, there to trace the homeward bee, that's the way for Billy and me. Let us move on for the next page, children. Where the hazel bank is steepest, where the shadow falls the deepest, where the clustering nuts fall free, that's the way for Billy and me. Why the boy should drive away little sweet maidens from the play, or love to banter and fight so well, that's the thing I never could tell. But this I know, I love to play through the meadow among the hay, up the water and over the lea, that's the way for Billy and me. Yes, children, while I am reading the poem, you all should open the textbook and keep the finger wherever I am reading. Understood? Yes, children. Now, let us go for the explanation part. Yes. Where the pools are bright and deep, where the grey trout lies asleep, up the river and over the lea, that's the way for Billy and me. Your children, the boy and his friend Billy go up the river and over the lea. What do you mean by lea, children? Lea is nothing but an open area covered with grass. Understood? Yes. Lea, to reach the pools and enjoy watching bright pools and the great trout with sleep under the water. What do you mean by trout, children? Trout is nothing but a kind of fish. So they wanted to see the fish which is playing in the pool under the water, which is sleeping under the water. Understood? Yes. Second stanza, children. Where the blackbird sings the latest, where the hawthorn blooms the sweetest, where the nestlings chirp and flee, That's the way for Billy and me. Means that's the way Billy and me wanted to play. Who is Billy? Billy and his friend, they both are playing in the nature. Understood? Yes. Let us see second stanza, children. Here the poet is trying to say that the poet loves to hear the blackbird sing. Understood? He likes to hear the blackbird sing and see the hawthorn blooms. Hawthorn is nothing but, children, it is a thorny shrub with red berries. Understood? It is a shrub which will be having red berries. Okay, so the poet loves to hear the blackbird sing and see the hawthorn's blooms. And he wanted to see the hawthorn blooms. Okay, at some time he cannot stop admiring the little bird chirping from inside the nest. And also he is getting admired by the chirping of the bird which is in the nest. Nestling is nothing but, what do you mean by nestling, children? Nestling is nothing but where a young bird live in the nest. You know nest alva guttala, goodu akkigal irthavalla, that one. Okay, so yen aagtide poet ge, and also is feeling very, what is getting admired andre a nestling na nodid takshna a bird nododike avange tumba khushi aagta ide. Understood? Bird chirping andre bird sound maduttala makla, that one. That's the way. So he is saying that's the way for Billy and me. That is the way for Billy and me to play. Understood? Let us go for the next stanza, children. Where the mowers mow the cleanest, where the hay lies thick and greenest, there to trace the homeward bee, that's the way for Billy and me. So here, children, what the poet is saying, here, children, he is saying that the poet watches, what the poet is observing there, children, the poet watches the mowers. Mowers is nothing but, children, a machine used for grass cutting. Grass na cut martarala, that machine is called as mowers. So the poet watches mowers, that they are busy at work. They are busy at work cutting the grass, moving the area where the hay is thickest and greenest. Andre yelli jaga thick agi green agi belkondibittirutala grass. Hay is nothing but, children, ullu, dried grass. Andre grass vanagi enagutte, it will turn to yellow color, no, ull tara, that is hay. Okay, so moving the area where the hay is thickest and greenest. Thickest matte greenest iro jagadalli they are cutting the grass. So the poet is watching that. Understood? And he also follows the bees towards his home, and also is following the bees. Bees andre eno, hulagalu, jenulagalu ella artha iruttala. So he is just following the bees to his home. Avar mane kadege adanna follow martta hogta idane ibru kuda hogta idare. Understood? Yes, let us go for the next stanza in the next page, children. Where the hazel bank is steepest, where the shadow falls the deepest, where the clustering nuts fall free, that's the way for Billy and me. So, your children, the poet collects the nuts that falls from the hazel tree. Hazel is nothing but a small tree, children. So, he's collecting the nuts which has been fallen. Understood? And also the shade of the tree makes the shadow deep where the nuts are found. So the shade of the tree makes the shadows. The shade, you know, no neral biddag enagutte a shadow kaanutalva. So because of that they are able to find the nuts. Understood? That's the way for Billy and me. So that is the way for Billy and his friend. Okay, next stanza. Why the boy should drive away little sweet maidens from the play, or love to banter and fight so well, that's the thing I never could tell. So here, children, the poet tells that I cannot understand a thing, why boys drive away the girls from the play. Yes or no, children? Boys will drive away andre odisbidtaralva aatadinda girls na. Yes, why? I couldn't understand that, the poet is telling here. Or love to banter. Banter is nothing but, children, is nothing but to tease or to make friendly jokes. Okay, so why the, and also why the poet is saying that why boys like to banter. Banter is nothing but to tease and make friendly jokes and also fight so well, and also they like to fight, right? Yes, so he's telling that that's the thing I never could tell. So that is the thing I couldn't understand why it is like that. Okay, next answer, children. But this I know, I love to play through the meadow, among the hay, up the water and over the lea. That's the way for Billy and me. In the last stanza, the poet is trying to say that, children, he loves to play in the meadow. What do you mean by meadow, children? Meadow is nothing but a grassland, which is fully covered with grassland, is called as meadow. Okay, a piece of grassland. So he loves to play in grassland among the hay. Among the hay, hay means, as I told before, it is a dried grass. Okay, cut and dried grass is there. No, that is called as hay. Up the water over the lea, and he likes to play up the water over the lea. I have also told the meaning of lea, children, and open area covered with grass. Okay, and at the last, so again he's telling that that's the way for Billy and me. That is the way to play for me and Billy and his friend. Understood? So children, in this poem, the poet is trying to convey the message that this poem is admiring the beauty of nature. Okay, in this poem we can see that it is admiring the beauty of nature, right? And also it is telling that nature is very beautiful and everybody likes nature and all the children likes to play in nature. Yes or no, children? Yes. So hope you all have understood the poem which was very beautiful about nature. No children? Yes, children. Yes. And later I will send you the meanings and the notes on this poem in the next video, children. So please complete the notes. Okay, and read the poem once again and try to understand the poem. Okay, have a wonderful day, children. Thank you.